Good morning children. In this video we are going to learn angles made by a transversal. Children, here I have drawn a figure. In this figure line N intersects line L and line M at two different points. Therefore we can say that line N is a transversal of line L and line M. Therefore, line M is a transversal. Now, here 8 angles are formed. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8. Now, in the given table, we have to write which angles are interior angles, which angles are exterior angles, which angles form pairs of corresponding angles, which angles form pairs of alternate interior angles and so on. Students, here no specific definition is given for these angles or pairs of angles, but we have to identify these angles or pairs of angles by observing their positions in the given figure. By observing their positions in the given figure. Now first, interior angles. Now children, if you observe this figure, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6 are in the interior part of this figure. Therefore, we can say that angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are the interior angles. Therefore, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are the interior angles. Now, exterior angles. Now children, in this figure, angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are in the exterior part of the figure. Therefore, these angles are called exterior angles. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8. Therefore, these angles are called exterior pairs of corresponding angles. Children, this is transversal, and if you consider only left side angles of this transversal, then the pair of upper angles and pair of lower angles are called pairs of corresponding angles. Now if you consider right side angles of the transversal, then pair of upper angles, that is 2 and 6, and pair of lower angles, that is 3 and 7, are called pairs of corresponding angles. Therefore, in this figure, angle 1 and angle 5, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 2 and angle 6, angle 3 and angle 7 are the pairs of corresponding angles. Therefore, we write here angle 1 and angle 5, second angle 4 and angle 8, third angle 2 and angle 6, and fourth angle 3 and angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 6, angle 3 and angle 7. Therefore, in this way, in this figure, there are 4 pairs of corresponding angles. First, second, this third and this one, fourth. Now, next, pairs of alternate interior angles. Now, you see, in this figure, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are the interior angles. Now, among these interior angles, angle 4 and angle 6 and angle 3 and angle 5 are the pairs of alternate interior angles. I repeat, angle 4 and angle 6, angle 3 and angle 5 are the pairs of alternate interior angles. Therefore, we write here angle 4 and angle 6 and angle 3 and angle 5. Now next, pairs of alternate exterior angles. Now, in this figure, angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are the exterior angles. And among these angles, we have to identify pairs of alternate exterior angles. Therefore, angle 1 and angle 7, angle 2 and angle 8 are the pairs of alternate exterior angles. Therefore, angle 1 and angle 7 and angle 2 and angle 8. Are the pairs of alternate exterior angles. Now last, pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Now you see children, here there are four interior angles, but here we have to write pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Therefore, this is transversal and we have to write interior angle on the same side of the transversal, either left side or either right side. Therefore, angle 4 and angle 5 are the pair of angles on the same side of the transversal, and angle 3 and angle 6 are also pair of angles on the same side of the transversal. Therefore, angle 4 and angle 5, angle 3 and angle 6. Angle 4 and angle 5 and angle 3 and angle 6. These angles are on the same side of the transversal, and these angles are on the same side of the transversal, and these angles are interior angles. Here we have to take only interior angles. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you.